Welcome to English literature class, my dear students of class 11th. Now I'm going to start Act 2, Scene 2 from The Tempest. Please open your books and read and try to understand the scene, Act 2, Scene 2. Here in this scene, what happens? Listen. First of all, Caliban, bearing his locks, meets Trinculo. Bearing his locks, as the work was given by Prospero to collect the fuel for him, so he bearing his locks meets Trinculo. He believes him to be one of the spirits whom Prospero sent to torture him. As a storm is blowing, Trinculo takes shelter under the cloak of Caliban. A long loose garment is called cloak. The two are lying, the two means here Caliban and Trinculo are lying together on the ground when Stefano staggers being drunk. Stefano gives Caliban a drink from his bottle. Caliban, taking him for a god, enters gladly into his service. Now what happens? Listen, another part of the island, scene 2, another part of the island, enter Caliban with a burden of wood, a noise of thunder heard. Caliban says, all the infections that the sun sucks up from box, fence, flat, on Prospero fall and make him by inch meal a disease. His spirits hear me and yet I need must cause, must curse, but they will not pinch, fright me with urchin shows, pitch me in the mire, nor lead me like a fire brand in the dark out of my way, unless he bid them. But for every trifle are they set upon me, sometimes like apes that maw and chatter at me, and after bite me. Then, like hedgehog which lie tumbling in my barefoot way and mount their pricks at my football. Caliban curses Prospero here and says, may all infections which the sun sucks up from the bogs, from the marshes and low ground affect Prospero. He should be affected. Let them make him suffer all over his body from disease. His spirits can hear me. He is sure that his spirits, the spirits of Prospero, can hear me. Can hear me. Me means here Caliban. But I must curse him. He is adamant here. But they would not trouble me or frighten me with coming of imps. Imps means evil spirit. Throw me down in the mud. Nor could they lead me astray by making me follow deceptive shadows in the darkness, unless Prospero orders them to do so. He is sure that unless Prospero orders them to torture me, to prick me, they won't do this job. But for a small fault, he sets them upon me. If I do a very small trifle work, very small, smallest thing, smallest fault, he sets them upon me, he sets the spirits upon me. Sometimes in the shape of monkeys, they make faces and chatter at me, and afterwards bite me. They seem like porcupines which lie in the way which I walk bare feet. Sometimes they seem like porcupines. The spirits seems like porcupines which lie in the way when I walk bare feet, and hurt with me their spines, and hurt me with their spines. He says, sometimes I am all wound which adders, who with cloven tongues do hiss me into madness, lo, now lo. Sometimes I am wounded by snakes, I am bitten by snakes, who with me their forked tongues ही सेट मी एंड ड्राइव मी मैड. सी नाउ हियर कम्स आवर स्पिरिट. लो नाउ लो हियर एक्सक्लेमेशन हियर. सी नाउ हियर कम्स आवर स्पिरिट. हियर कम्स आवर स्पिरिट ऑफ हिज एंड टू टॉर्मेंट मी फॉर ब्रिंगिंग वुड इन स्लोली. ही थिंक्स दैट एज ही इज ब्रिंगिंग द वुड वेरी स्लोली देयर फोर Prospero has sent one of his spirits. I will fall flat. Perchance he will not mind me. Now he has an idea. He thinks that if he lies flat on the ground, the spirits won't be able to see him. So he lies down here. He says, I will lie flat and perhaps he will pay no heed to me, paid no attention to me. Lie down. Caliban lie down on the ground. Enter Trinculo. Trinculo, here in the scene, he comes Trinculo. He has neither bush nor shrub. As there is thunder and lightning, so Trinculo wants to, he is searching for some shelter. So he says, he has neither bush nor shrub to bear of any weather at all, and another storm brewing. I hear it sing in the wind, yawn some black cloud, and huge one looks like a foul bombard that would shed his liquor. If it should thunder as it did before, I know not where to hide my head. He thinks, here there is no bush. He is searching for the shelter. So he says he has no bush nor shrub for shelter against the bad weather. And another storm is likely to come. I can hear it whistling in the wind. The same black cloud over there, that huge one, looks like a foul pot of wine about to pour out its contents. It should thunder as it did before. He remembers the time when Prospero raised the storm and he was in the ship. If it should thunder as it did before, I do not know where I can take shelter. He is worried about his shelter. Now, he says, I know not where I to hide my head. Yearned, same cloud cannot choose but fall be by pale fools. What have we here? What does he see? The same cloud will bring heavy rain. Why? What is this? Now, as you know, Caliban is lying on the ground. So he says, who is he? A man or a fish? He says, a man or a fish? Dead or alive? A fish. He smells like a fish. A very ancient and fish-like smell, a kind of knot of the newest poor John. A strange fish were I in England now, as once I was, and had but this fish painted, not a holiday fool there, but would give a piece of silver. They would, this monster make a man, any strange beast there makes a man. Says here, is it man or fish? Is it dead or alive? It is a fish. Now he confirms, ensures himself that it is a fish. He smells like a fish. He has a fish-like smell. A smell like that of a dried cod. Cod is a type of fish. A strange fish. Peculiar type of fish that was. I wish I were in England. Trinculo wishes here. If I were in England, where I once was, and that I had this fish advertised on a painted board, it would be advertised by me. The fools on a holiday would pay a silver coin to see him. By this way, I could earn some money. There, this monster would surely make a huge fortune. By this monster, I would surely make a huge wealth. any strange beast there makes a man. When they will not give or do it to relieve a lame beggar, they will lazy out tent to see a dead Indian. He says here, when they refuse to give a penny to a lame beggar, people do not like to give a penny to a lame beggar, they will give 10 pennies, 10 for a look at a dead Indian. Legged like a man and his fins like arms, warm, oh my troth, I do now let loose my opinion, hold it no longer, this is no fish but an islander that hath lately suffered by a thunderbolt. Now he makes idea, he has legs like a man and his fins are like arms, he is warm indeed, I must now deliver my opinion and can withhold it no longer, this is not a fish but a native of this island. Finally he makes an idea that it is not a fish, he is a native of this island. He seems to have suffered from lightning. Thunder is heard. Alas, the storm is come again. My best way is to creep under his gabardine, loose garment. There is no other shelter here about. Misery acquaints a man with strange bedfellows. I will hear shroud till the dregs of the storm be past. Now he says to himself, it is better to creep under his cloak, for there is no other shelter here. Misery makes a man put up with strange companions. If in bad times, people put up with strange companions. I will take shelter till the remaining portion of the storm has passed over. Creep under Caliban's garment. Enter Stefano singing a bottle in his hand. What happens? Stefano singing song here. I shall no more to see here shall I die ashore. This is a very scurvy tune to sing at a man's funeral. Well, here's my comfort. I will go no more to sea, but I will die ashore. This is a terrible tune to sing at a man's funeral. Well, he has some wine to comfort me. He drinks. The master, the swabber, the boatswain, and I, the gunner and his mate, loved Moll, Meg, and Marian, and Marjorie, but none of us cared for Kate. The captain, he sings here, the captain, the deck cleaner, the bosun, and I, the gunner and his mate, loved Mary, Meg, Marian, and Marjorie, but none of us cared for Kate. For she had tongue with a tang, would cry to a sailor, go hang. So loved not to savor for tar nor for pitch, then to see boys and let her go hang. This is a scurvy tune too, but here's my comfort. For she had a tongue that was sharp, she would cry to a sailor, go and hang yourself. She did not like the smell of tar or pitch, so let's go to sea and let her go and hang herself. That is another terrible song, but he has some wine for comfort. He drinks and sings. He drinks again. Caliban says, do not torment me, oh. As you know, this is humorous scene as well, of this scene. Humor is here. You can find humor here in this scene. Caliban, here Trinculo is in his cloak. Trinculo is in Caliban's cloak. So, he disturbs Caliban. So, Caliban said, do not torment me, Caliban. Caliban said, do not torment me, oh, Stefano. What the matter? Have we devils here? Stefano just passed from there. He says, what's the matter? Have we devils here? Do you put tricks upon with savages and men of Ind? Ha! I have not escaped drowning to be afeared. now of your 4 legs, for it hath been said, as proper a man as ever went on 4 legs cannot make him give ground. And it shall be said so again while Stephano breathes our nostrils. Stephano says, what is the matter? Do we have devils here? Are you tricking us with savages and men of India? I have not escaped donning to be frightened now by your 4 legs. Sorry. Now he says to himself that Droning, he cannot be frightened, but now by 4 legs, your 4 legs, for it has been said that the best man who ever walked on 4 legs cannot make me yield, cannot make me reward. It will be said again till Stephano lives. Caliban says, the spirit torments me. Oh, do not torment me. Caliban thinks that as he was carrying the fuel very slowly, so Prospero has sent a spirit to torture him. But this is not the truth, you know. He says, oh, do not torment me. Stephano says, this is some monster of the isle with 4 legs who hath got, as I take it, an ague. Where the devil should we learn our language? Stephano said, there is a monster of the island with 4 legs. He makes idea here that this is a monster of the island with 4 legs who has got some fever. Therefore he is trembling. Where the devil could he have learned our language? He is speaking the same language, our language. I will help him because I will give. He says, I will give him some relief if it be but for that. If I can recover him and keep him tame and get to Naples with him, he is a present for any emperor that ever trod on needs leather. He says to himself, I will help him because he speaks our language. I can help him because he speaks our language. If I can make him recover, tame him, and take him to Naples with me. He thinks this is a strange creature who has 4 legs, so he can be tamed and maybe taken to Naples with me. He is fit to be offered as a present to any emperor whoever wore shoes made of ox leather. Caliban says, do not torment me. Prithee, I will bring my wood home faster. He thinks that Prospero has sent a spirit to torture him. So he says, do not torment me, please. I will bring home the wood faster. Stephano says he is in his fit now and does not talk after the wish wisest. He shall taste of my bottle if he have never drunk wine afore. Will go near to remove his fit. If I can recover him and keep him tame, I will not take too much for him. He shall pay for him that hath him, and that soundly. Stephano says he has his shivering fit now and does not speak sensibly. He has been suffering from fever, and that's why he is unable to speak sensibly. I will give him a taste of my bottle. I will pour some drops of wine into his mouth. If he is not used to drinking wine, it will cure him of his fit. He will be recovered if he has never used wine. If I can revive and tame him, I will not ask high a price for him. If he would be tamed, I will not take a high price for him. Whoever gets him will pay well for him. The person who will get him will pay a good money for him. Caliban said, thou dost me yet but little hurt. Thou wilt anon आई नो इट बाय द ट्रेम्बलिंग नाउ प्रॉस्पर वॉक्स अपॉन दी. कैलिबन सेज यू हैव नॉट हर्ट मी मच येट, यू विल हर्ट मी सून, आई कैन टेल बाय द वे यू आर ट्रेम्बलिंग, प्रॉस्परो इज वर्किंग अपॉन यू. ही थिंकिंग हिमसेल्फ, प्रॉस्पर इज वर्किंग ऑन मी, ही थिंक्स. स्टेफानो सेज कम ऑन योर वेज, ओपन योर माउथ, हियर इज दैट विच विल गिव लैंग्वेज टू यू. कैट ओपन योर माउथ, दिस विल शेक योर शेकिंग, आई कैन टेल यू एंड दैट साउंडली. गिव्स कैलिबन ड्रिंक, यू कैन नॉट टेल हु इज योर फ्रेंड, ओपन योर चैप्स अगेन. स्टेफानो सेज कम ऑन, ओपन योर माउथ, हियर इज अ ड्रिंक विच विल मेक अ कैट स्पीक, इवन अ कैट कैन स्पीक if she drinks. Open your mouth, this will relieve your ague, this will relieve you from acute fever. Give Caliban some wine. You do not know who are your friends. Open your mouth again. You do not know who are your friends. Open your mouth again. Trinculo says, I should know that wise it should be, but he is doomed, and these are devils. Oh, defend me. Trinculo was with Stefano in the ship, so he thinks, I could recognize that wise. I have heard this wise earlier. I could recognize that wise. It should be, but he is doomed. He thinks that Stefano is doomed. How can he speak? And these speaking here are devils. God protect me. Stefano says, 4 lakhs and 2 vices. 4 lakhs and 2 vices. One time, sometime Trinculo speaks and sometime Caliban. And 2 lakhs of Caliban and 2 lakhs of Trinculo. 4 lakhs. 4 lakhs and 2 voices, a most delicate monster. His forward voice now is to speak well of his friend. His backward voice is to utter foul speeches and to detract. If all the wine in my bottle will recover him, I will help his ague. Come, give Caliban drink again. Amen. I will pour some in the other mouth. There are 2 mouths, you know, here one of Trinculo or one of Caliban. Stefano says, it has 4 lakhs and 2 vices. He is truly a monster. His first voice speaks well of his friend. His second voice utters foul speeches and abuses. If all the wine in my bottle will make him recover, I will help his ague. I will help his acute fever. Come, gives Caliban more wine. That's enough. I will pour some into your mouth, your other mouth. He thinks there is one man who has 2 mouths. Trinculo, Stefano. Stefano said, doth thy other mouth call me? Mercy, mercy. This is a devil and no monster. I will leave him. I have no long spoon. Stefano says, is that other mouth calling to me? Mercy, mercy, this is a devil and not a monster. I will leave him, for it is said, he who sups means sip, with the devil needs a long spoon. He thinks he is needed long spoon because he is with devil. So he says, he who sips with the devil needs a long spoon. Trinculo says, Stefano, if thou beest Stefano, touch me and speak to me, for I am Trinculo. Be not afeard, thy good friend Trinculo. Now he recognized that he is my friend Stefano, and Stefano understood that Trinculo, who is my best friend, who is my friend. Trinculo says, Stefano, if you are Stefano, touch me and speak to me. I am Trinculo. So do not afraid of me. I am your friend, Trinculo. Stefano says, if thou beest Trinculo come forth, I will pull thee by the lesser legs. If any be Trinculo's leg, these are they. Draws Trinculo's out, thou art very Trinculo indeed. How comest thou to be here? He asks. If your Trinculo come out, if your Trinculo come out from the cloak, I will pull you out by the smaller pair of legs. A smaller pair of legs. If any, it means Trinculo was not of a long height. If any are Trinculo's legs, these are they. Draws Trinculo out. You are indeed Trinculo. You are really Trinculo. Really you are Trinculo. How did you come to here? Trinculo says, I took him to be killed with a thunder stroke, but art thou not drowned, Stefano? Trinculo asks question to Stefano. I thought that he had been killed by the lightning. But were you not drowned, Stefano? I hope now thou art now drowned. Is the storm overblown? I hid my under the dead moon calf's gabardine for fear of the storm. And art thou living, Stefano? O Stefano, two Neapolitans escaped. Neapolitans who lives in Naples. He says, but were you not drowned, Stefano? I think now you are not drowned. Has the storm subsided? I hid myself under the cloak of this dead monster for fear of the storm. And are you alive, Stefano? Oh, Stefano, we are two men from Naples who have escaped. Now they think that only two, these are the two persons who are, who were saved from the tempest raised by Prospero. Stefano says, Prithi, do not turn me about. My stomach is not constant. Stefano says, please do not pull me about. My stomach is upset. Caliban aside, these be fine things, and if they be not spirits, that's brave God and pious celestial liquor, I will kneel to him. He never tasted the wine. He likes it. And now he wants more and says, these are good creatures. He makes an idea about Stefano and Trinculo and says, these are good creatures if they are not spirits. Now he assured himself that these Trinculo and Stefano are not spirits sent by Prospero. If they are not spirits, he is a brave god and carries heavenly drink with him. I will kneel before him. Stefano says, how didst thou escape? How camest thou hither? Swear by this bottle, how thou camest hither? I escaped upon a butt of a sack, which the sailors heaved overboard by this bottle, which I made of the bark of a tree with mine own hand, since I was cast ashore. Stefano now says how he was escaped. He says, how did you escape from the shipwreck? How did you reach here? Swear by this bottle and tell me how you came here. I escaped, he says about himself. Stefano says about himself, I escaped floating on a large cask of wine which the sailors had thrown overboard. I swear by this bottle which I made with my hand from the bark of a tree after I was driven ashore. With the help of large cask of wine, I was driven ashore. Caliban says, I will swear upon that bottle to my thy true subject, for the liquor is not earthly. Caliban says, I swear by the bottle to be your true subject, for liquor is a heavenly drink. he is sure now that liquor is a heavenly drink. So they have come from heaven. Stephano says, here swear then how thou escapedest. Stephano says, here is a bottle, swear then and tell me how you escaped drowning. Trinculo says, swim ashore man like a duck, I can swim like a duck, I will be sown. Trinculo says, I swam ashore, I can swim very well, so I swam ashore man like a duck, I swear that I can swim like a duck. He says, I swear that I can swim like a duck. And what happens after that, you will study in my next video. Thank you so much, students.